Now this is the last question, that is question number 6 of exercise 11.3. Here we will learn how to prepare a bill. Okay, so Divya is buying 2 salwar suits, 3 jeans, 2 shirts and 4 pair of sandals. Complete the bill for the items purchased using the given rate list. This is your rate list: cost of 1 salwar suit, cost of jeans, cost of shirt, cost of sandal and cost of earrings is provided to you in the question. So we have to make a bill. In the bill, you can see already the bill is there in the question again. Now what you will do, you have to first try to understand how we are making the bill. Okay, so first you have to make a rectangular box in this way. Use a pencil because somewhere you may need to rub any line or anything. Okay, so better is for the first starting you use a pencil and a scale because straight lines are needed. Okay, give the heading as school trends. Why? Because the bill is prepared by this shop, school trends. And in the side of the where you have given the heading, then you have to mention the bill number and the date on which you have purchased the bill. It is already given in the question. What is the bill number? It is 125 and give today's date. What is our today's date? That is 15 November. 15-11-2020. This is the date on which this bill is made. Now we will start mentioning the other things. See, you can see below the, at the side of this bill, I have made another one line also. Why? Because we are partitioning. This particular column is meant only to write down the amount. Okay, and how is the amount written? The amount is written in rupees as well as in paise, like this. I have splitted, keep less width for the paise part because only 2 digits are there. Okay, so this is enough. Now we will fill the other columns. Now we have to make the other columns. The first column is SL number. Make a thin one like this. Then you have to make a column for the name of the items that you are purchasing. That will be little bit thicker. And then you have to divide the rest into 2 halves. One is for quantity and another is for, this is your SL number, this is your item names. One is for quantity and next is price. Actually it is unit price. Unit price means the each item, one item, what is the cost. So we are writing unit price and this is also mentioned in terms of rupees. Now let us see the first item that is purchased by Divya is salwar suit. So how many salwar suit is she buying? She is buying 2 salwar suits. It's given in the question very clearly. And cost of 1 salwar suit is rupees 450, that is given in the rate list. So we'll write here rupees 450. Now we have to mention the amount. Amount, how we will do? Quantity multiplied by the unit price will give you the amount. So rupees 450 into 2, that is rupees 900. 900 under paise, you write 00. The next item that she is purchasing is jeans. So number 2 is jeans. How many jeans? 3 jeans. And the rate is rupees 875. Let us take out the amount. We will multiply 875 by 3. 5 threes are 15, carry 1. 7 threes are 21 plus 1, 22, carry 2. 8 threes are 24 plus 2, 26. So rupees 2625.00. The next item is 2 shirts. So SL number 3. And the item name is shirts. Quantity will be 2. Price of one shirt is rupees 325. Now we need to multiply 325 by 2. 325 into 2 is 650. The next item is sandals. How many pairs of sandals he is getting? She is getting, that is 4. And one pair of sandal cost is rupees 522. We need to multiply 522 by 4. So multiply 522 by 4. 4 2 is 8, 5 4 is 20. So it is 2088.00. Now let us take out the grand total. I made another box down. I have just extended the row below like this. Leave this part for writing the grand total. And I am mentioning also what I will write. That is grand total. Now let me add this to get the final amount that Divya is going to pay for this amounts to the shopkeeper. 5 plus 8 is 13. See, paise part there is nothing. So it will be same 00 only. Here it will be 13, carry 1. 2 plus 1, 3 plus 5, 8 plus 8, 16, carry 1. 9 plus 1, 10 plus 6, 16 plus 6, 22, 2, carry 2. 2 plus 2, 4 plus 2, 6. So we got the final answer as rupees 6,263 and 00 paise. So this is how we are preparing the bill. You all have to remember these column names. These are very important. We will just like this, we will tell you to prepare a bill, make a bill for this particular person, or what will be the grand total of this, of the bill, who has purchased, whose items are this and this, quantities this and this, unit prices this and this. Okay, we can give you the price list like that, and we can tell you to prepare the bill. So you have to remember this method, you have to remember this format of making the bill.